Hi everybody, welcome back. Back opening addict. Modern Horizons 2 set boosters. I know at the time of this filming, the prices on all of this product has almost kind of assumed it might happen because of the fast release schedule and the price of these boxes and all of that. Ah, this one was what, $225? I mean, okay, sure, let's crack another one. I don't know if I'm going to actually hold on to any of this product right now because I'm kind of wondering where the bottom is. So, let's crack another one of these because I can't get enough. I don't know if the general public can. Now, if you're new to the channel, I do post daily videos, usually at 7 a.m. Pacific Standard Time, 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. And once in a while, I'll have a early night video. Kind of just depends on what I have in the queue. So these are the Japanese. Yeah, Japanese. Made in Japan. Okay. So these are the Japanese ones. Okay. So that's why they're backwards like that. So we'll get through the commons. Then you're going to get to the uncommons of varying amounts. For our first rare, Chitter Spitter. Then into the reprint uncommon or rare, so Mishra's Factory, Sketch Card, and to start us off, we have Old Bordered Foil Ignoble Hierarch. Nice start, nice start. Okay. Oh, this set. I think people are bored of it at this point, so I don't know. I'm probably going to post this. I have a lot of other stuff in the queue, but I'm probably going to post this video. I will admit, I am not excited at all for Dungeons & Dragons. It feels like it's an amazing limited experience. It really feels like the set subtlety for our first mythic. Very nice. But it kind of feels like it was well designed for that aspect, which is cool. But for cracking's sake, doesn't feel... we're going to put fetches over there. Okay, so Profane Tutor will go over here. For cracking's sake, doesn't feel great. Like, it just doesn't look... And we got Ruined Stalactite for our first list card. I'm going to shift things over here slightly to give us space for all the pylons that you can get out of these. There we go. That's better. All right. But what was I saying? So it looks like it's an amazing experience for that. But it really doesn't look like it's an overly exciting set for random cracks. So I'm going to do some for the channel because I do want to open some. We'll see how many I do. Prismatic Ending. Okay. I have a feeling it won't be a ton. Solitary Confinement. Dreadmaw and nothing. Okay. So I hope that doesn't disappoint people. Yeah, and I'm going to do some. It's just not going to be... You know, like these other types of, box cracking experiences that are fun, like Modern Horizons 2 here, or even Modern Horizons 1, or Double Masters, or Zendikar Rising Collectors, or, you know, it kind of goes on and on here. Okay. Nykdos Paragon Sketch. Wonder. Late to Dinner. Gargadon, nothing. Okay. So far, a pretty decent start out of the first... four packs here. Okay. Commons. Strike It Rich. Glimpse of Tomorrow. Sanctifier and Vec. Scourge. Familiar. And Arcbound Shikari. Chatterstorm. Alright. Okay. Let's find something cool now. There's a couple weak packs in a row. A lot of commons. Dragon's Rage Channeler. You know, I saw a thread where people were kind of discussing Goblin Guide and its drop in price point. And one person's like, well, yeah, look at the one drops that just came out in Modern. Thrasta. Just become a bit of a troll on this channel. Because I can't not pull Thrasta. One box alone, I had three separate variations of Thrasta. Slow Talisman. And nothing. And Training Grounds. That's actually a pretty cool hit. So we have Training Grounds out of the list slot. That's actually pretty nice. Okay. That just kind of snuck up on me there. There's a training grounds there. It's like card, yeah, all, you know, just the junk in the back of the pack. Oh, hey, what's that? Okay, so we got one of those heavy uncommon packs. Fey Offering, Spreading Insurrection, Captain Ripley Vance, Thranduin Watcher, Flame Tongue Yearling, Rise and Shine, Yusri, Girl Shaman, and nothing. Okay. You know, the first set boxes that were cracked, it looked like when you had those packs that gave you tons of uncommons and no commons. Like, those were the packs that brought the heat. And in my subsequent experiences, and I know other channels kind of had those same types of packs, like, early on, it felt like they were just bringing all the beef. And now, not so much. Prophetic Titan, Gedron de Hada for the Borderless Mythic. Calibrated Blast, and Sea Drake, Chatterstorm, nothing. No fetches yet, though. And three mythics in already. And that's another thing. You either get a lot of fetchies or a lot of mythics. And most people would kind of prefer the fetchies. Okay, I just like threw a Yavimaya, a now heavy played Yavimaya Cradle of Growth. Okay, it's fine. Alright. Oh, we got a Yavimaya. Okay, sweet. Is there an orb? Faithless Salvaging, Out of Time Foil. Okay. And last pack of the first row. Got a Foil Swampy. Scuttletide. Specimen Collector. Esper Sentinel. Very nice. By the way, it's like time to buy these is now. Squirrel Mob, Mystic Reduction, and nothing, okay? Alright, so into the middle row. Still don't love the pull tabs. Still don't love them. Really, really don't love them. I'm sure there's a good reason why they exist. Break the Ice, Tide Shaper, Suspend, Flame Rift, Step Through, Glimmer Baron, and nothing. And I can't hold on to stuff today. Alright. Okay, so that's 11 packs in. No fetches yet. It's a little up there in the disappointment level. Not that we haven't had good hits, but you know what I mean. You know what I mean. It's the fetchy quest after all. I know we have some people be like, you got good stuff. Stop whining. I'm not whining. I want fetchies. Give me the fetchies. Magus of the Bridge. Seal of Cleansing. Ornithopter of Paradise. And nothing. All right. Come on, fetchy. It's too many packs for that one. It is time that you bring a fetchy to the party. Oops, and we are getting crazy here with the focus. All right, Liquid Metal Torque, Foundation Breaker, Sanctum Weaver. Okay, that actually will go up in there. Seal of Removal, Either Sworn Sphinx, Arcbound Shikari. Okay, a whole lot of uncommons. All right, now fetchy. Okay, Tireless Provisioner. Sanctuary Raptor. Oh, okay, finally! Our first fetchy, Misty Rainforest. Excellent. Okay, and a Sterling Grove. And Soul Migration, and nothing. Okay. Alright, now let's get an old border one, eh? Yeah? And now am I asking for too much? Actually, I would love to see an Endurance. Let's see that. Yes, I'm coming around on that card. Scion of Draco, because I get one of those in every single box that I open, quite literally. Same thing with Thrasta. Tragic Fall, nothing. Okay. So secret to those packs is stop pulling on them like an animal. And we got signature card. What's that? Step through you. Yeah, okay. Oop. A lot of uncommons. Okay, Scurry Oak, Sovereign. So it's a squirrel. Could you imagine drafting with this and then that's the pack that you get? Gee, wonder what I'm going to play. That's why people don't draft with these, huh? All right, Persist. Moderation, Yabamaya Elder, Jade Avenger, and Captured by Legex. Middle row is not doing as well as the first row, even with a fetchy. Unless you want to give us two fetchies out of it. I would accept that. I would say, okay, well, thank you. Renrun's Hydra, Dothy Voidwalker, okay. Goblin Bombardment, Aeromoeba, Kieran, and Frost Titan. Wasn't this part of the very recent, what do they call those? What do they always call those? The Secret Layers, right? Wasn't this part of the a recent Secret Layer release too? Like, is that actually a good pull? I don't know. I feel like it is, but I know it's not as good as Training Grounds. But I will say, that's pretty cool. Did not expect that, and that's okay. Obviously, it's a mythic. And the Underworld Hermit. Bray's Apprentice for the first rare. Maybe the only rare. Greed. Liquid Metal Torkoal Border. Nothing. Okay. Two packs left of the middle. Can we pull out another Fetchland? Can we pull out an Urza's Saga? Can we pull another mythic that isn't named Garth One-Eye? Okay, Mono Skip. Well, okay, buried the lead on that. It's not Garth One Eye, but eh. Okay. You know what? I'm not going to bother. Esmora. Titania, Protector of Argoth. And nothing. Esmora, Nomardic, that little turn right there, and then it ends at Koldakar. But that little turn right there, I just can't spit it out. Adastina, Esmora, Nomardic, Adastina, Koldakar. Is that how you say it? Did I just say it right? Esmora, Nomardic, Adastina, Koldakar. Somebody let me know if I just said that correct, please. Okay, Persist. Counterspell. Abundant Harvest. Captain Ripley Vance. All right. Last part of the box. Let's hope the fetchies start showing up, huh? Okay, a lot of commons in that one. So we got the Arcbound Shikari, Obsidian Charma, Cursed Totem, Mind Collapse, Sudden Edict, and Alpha Cavu. I'm not even gonna bury the actual decent list pulls with that card. Let me try that. Okay. Sometimes I can tell, and people have commented on this, and it's something I'm working on. The focus sometimes tries to keep up with me, and I'm going too fast, and it can't. So it starts hopping like crazy, because it's not sure what to focus on. Okay, our second Gaedrone Dehada, this time in the traditional version. Soul Snare, and nothing. As of right now, I'm going to give this box a C. Very average, even with the Training Grounds. It could, it's definitely enough packs left to move that out of C territory, but right now it's a hard C. Select Strider, Capricomb, Power Depot. Okay, our second Ignoble. This time in the regular version. Extruder, Glimmer Baron with the goodest boy. And that look on his face. Look at that, look at that. Look at that look on his face. What is going on here? And a foil profane tutor. Okay, that's actually kind of cool. Don't mind that pool. Not spicy, but that's they did a really good job with foiling. Like, if you haven't opened these and you haven't gotten any foilings, like, they look spectacular. You know, I have to give Wizard some credit, even though I probably shouldn't, but they made a really expensive product here, and they made sure that it wasn't printed like crap, at least for the set boxes and the draft boxes, not including the old borders that of the commons and uncommons that they put in the collector packs that look like they're double printed. I know Paws Brown MTG corrected me on what it was, but I can't remember what it was that caused that. Inevitable Betrayal, Nesting Shambler, Goblin and Archomancer, and Birthing Bows. Okay. So what do we got left here? Six packs. Six packs and one fetchy. Okay, give me the fetchies. You will give me the fetchies. Right? Not. Yes. You saw it. Ha ha! Give me the fetchies. Misty Rainforest Old Bordered. That takes. Oh! That pack. Look at that. Okay. All right. I'm picking up what you're throwing down. Okay. Seal Removal, Terminal Agony. Okay. So that pack took this box from a hard C to a B plus. We still got five packs left to move on from B plus. That's amazing, right? I mean, that's amazing. Just Old Bordered, Misty, and Urza Saga. Same pack. Crazy. Makes every other pack look like junk. It's a Baz, like this one. Shardless Agent. Of course, that pack was kind of junk anyway. Shardless Agent's sweet, though. is a Baz seen play anywhere? Like, has anybody been able to make use of that card? Just a question. If anybody has the answer, please let me know. I will admit I haven't done any research on it. Okay, Dragon's Rage Channeler, Verdant Command, Patriarch's Bidding, Timeless Witness Sketch, Underworld Cookbook Foil, and Lash Out from Lorwyn. Okay. So three packs left. Let's see if we can get one more zesty pull here. And with that zesty pull not being a signature card, although that's pretty cool. Okay. All right. Blazing Root Walla, Feast of Sanity. Hey! This is a three Ignoble Hierarch box. Old Bordered Foil, Old Bordered, and the traditional version. Hey, Fury. Okay. All right. That's a seven Mythics. Okay. Gorilla Shaman. Nothing. Hey, Thought Vessel. Why not, right? Let's just toss a Thought Vessel into the list. I mean, that's cool. I'll take a Thought Vessel. All right. Okay. Two packs left. I think we've moved into A-minus territory here. Tell me if you disagree. I guess we could probably still be in B-plus territory. If I'm being overly critical. A-minus if we're not. Lucid Dreams. Dermo Taxi. Soul Snare, Faithless Salvaging, and a foil Old Bordered Soul Talisman. Okay. And last pack, everybody. Last pack. I will admit, so if we look at the board right now, so we've already pulled three Ignobles, Yavimaya, Esper Sentinel, Dothy Voidwalker, Urza's Saga. There could be a fetching here, but only two fetchies so far. Several of the other pretty solid rares. Seven Mythics so far, including a borderless one. There's probably Jack Squat in this pack. And yes, I moved my hands all the way so people can see the board. So I'm not expecting anything in the last minute here. All right, recalibrate. Oops, I don't read comments. Get past the comments. There we go. Mystic Redaction. Ghost Lit Drifter. Timeless Dragon. I always feel like Timeless Dragon is one of the last cards that you pull. Riptide Laboratory. Okay. Arcbound Mouser. Okay. Yep. So as I had figured, unless there was going to be a fetchy in that, that was going to be it for the video. Cool. Thanks for watching. That was still a pretty sweet box overall. That did not suck. So like, subscribe, comment. Check out some of my old videos too. Really, views matter more than subscribing. So, you know, check some of those out. I would appreciate that. You know, and thanks for watching. Bye.